Sputnik 5 and Sputnik Light. Yeah, I know they sound like spacecrafts or maybe like a cola light, but with the advent of newer vaccines into the market and Sputnik 5 and Sputnik Light going to be available at the hospital near you, and many of my friends asking me about the Russian vaccine Sputnik, I thought it is the right time for me to give you guys information so that I can encourage every one of you who's thinking about taking the Sputnik vaccine to go and take it if that's what you want. I'm Dr. Santosh Jacob, orthopedic surgeon and COVID-19 physician from the city of Chennai, Tamil Nadu in India. And I have been treating COVID-19 from March 2020, learning about it and trying to share information which would help you beat the disease, because I think information about a disease is the first step we take in order to conquer the disease. Coming to Sputnik 5 and Sputnik Light, I will be answering 6 of your questions, which will be: 1. Why was the Sputnik surrounded in so much of a controversy in the beginning? 2. What is unique about the Sputnik? 3. What do the actual phase 2 and phase 3 results say? 4. A note on Sputnik Light and its results from Argentina. 5. Why is the EMA and the EU, WHO not giving approvals to the Russian and the Indian vaccines? And also, what do I think of the Sputnik? Now, going straight into it, why was the Sputnik shrouded in controversy? Yes, we scientists and doctors were in a tiff, because in August 2020, the Russian Ministry of Health said that the Sputnik vaccine was okay to use and the government authorized it. And we were thinking, oh my God, the phase 1 and the phase 2 results are going to be out only after a month. And if the Russian Ministry of Health says that this vaccine is good, then what if the results are not as expected? Will they honestly tell us? 1. And the second thing is, if they are releasing the vaccine earlier, why wouldn't they alter the results later? But now we have answers to all these questions, and I for one heave a big sigh of relief as I make this video, because I'm quite happy with what I have learned about the Sputnik vaccine. Point number 2. What is so peculiar or unique about the Sputnik? Yes, the Sputnik, just like Johnson & Johnson and Oxford AstraZeneca, that is our Covishield, is an adenovirus vector vaccine. You guys know what it means. It just means that we take the spike protein of the COVID-19, put it into an adenovirus, which does not cause any disease in human beings, and we inject it into your muscle, and that creates antibodies which protect you against the COVID-19. What is peculiar is, in the first dose of Sputnik 5, we use a different adenovirus vector, and in the second dose, it is a different adenovirus vector. Both two doses do not have the same virus which takes the spike protein of the COVID-19 into our cells. Now, why is it important? This statement is from somebody who critically talks about the Sputnik. He's not from the institution which actually makes the vaccine. He says that if you have two different viral vectors, the ability of the vectors to take the spike protein into different cells improves, and that is one of the reasons he says that Sputnik is going to be a very good vaccine. Coming to point number 3, what do the phase 2 and the phase 3 results say? Yes, Sputnik was approved in August 2020. The phase 3 results were released in Jan and Feb. Now, I have broken them down into results from Russia and results from out of Russia, because Sputnik has been approved in more than 75 countries worldwide, and there are more than 500 million doses waiting to be imported to India. And so it is really important for us to know the phase 2 and phase 3 results. The Russian evidence does not talk about getting infected with the COVID-19, because that's not important if you have an asymptomatic infection. The protection rates which the Sputnik 5 offers is against symptomatic COVID-19 and severe disease. Against symptomatic COVID-19, the protection is 91.6% according to Russian studies, and against severe disease from COVID-19, it is above 97%, which means that if 100 people are vaccinated twice with the Sputnik V, then only 3 of them would get a severe form of COVID-19. And I think that is very, very good. Coming to the studies about Sputnik Light. So what is Sputnik Light? Sputnik Light is just a single dose vaccine, which you can take. And the plan is that it can be used as a booster for Sputnik V, or in countries where you need an emergency vaccination, where one dose is all that you can get, Sputnik Light is supposed to be useful there. And the results from Argentina, it is an independent study, not associated with Russia at all, that says that protection from Sputnik V severe disease is around 76% after a single dose of Sputnik Light. Now, this is the information which we have, which is more or less important about the evidence of phase 3. Coming to a very important point, which I'm sure is plaguing all your minds. So I have got down to the reasons as to why this approval could not be happening. Why is the EU and the WHO not recognizing the Indian and the Russian vaccines? Now, they are extremely worried that people from Asia will not report adverse side effects. So what are adverse side effects? Say somebody in a village in India or Russia takes the vaccine and they have a stroke. People will not relate it to the vaccine and they might not report it online like they do in the European Union or in America. Because guys, you know, people in India generally go to the doctor just maybe when they cannot bear it anymore. And I think, yes, there is some sense in it. And also, the other reason is there is a lot of documentation and evidence which has to be supported to get EU and WHO approval. And many times, this is not easy to do in the first attempt. So it's not that the WHO or EU has not given approval. They're just waiting for documents and they are waiting to see if there are any serious adverse effects. Again, why? Because just like the J&J and the Oxford AstraZeneca, that is our Covishield, Sputnik is also an adenovirus vector vaccine, but it has not showed adverse side effects of clotting like the other two. And scientists want to be absolutely sure that it is not because of non-reporting of the adverse effects. And that is the reason why it is taking so much time. Now that we have learned everything which you need to know about the Sputnik, what do I think? I think that most of the people who are thinking about the Sputnik are those who have got COVID-19 in the last 3 months. And now that they have this option, they want to take Sputnik. The thing is, guys, many times you do not get natural immunity from a COVID-19 infection. It does not happen in 20 to 25% of the cases. So what I would suggest is, before you wait and go and take the Sputnik or the Covaxin or the Covishield or Moderna, whenever it is available, do an analysis of the antibodies. Do an analysis of antibodies for SARS-CoV-2. Do an analysis of antibodies for the spike protein. And if you have antibodies, talk to your doctor about your antibodies and when you should take the second or the first dose of the vaccine if you have not been vaccinated. All right, guys, I hope my information about the Sputnik V and Sputnik Light was useful. And I hope it encouraged you, those who have taken the Sputnik already and those who are going to take it. And I hope that all of you understand that the third wave can be prevented. Can be prevented with the tools we have. We already have the tools to make sure the third wave doesn't happen. So let us change our habits and make sure our city, our state, our country is saved from the third wave. All right, guys, signing off, Dr. Santosh Jacob. See you soon in another video. Bye-bye.